Let's discuss about ECG signal. That what is ECG signal first of all? ECG signal, as it is a electrocardiogram, is a test which measures the electrical activity of your heart to show whether or not it is working normally or not. And this is a QRS complex, we say Q graph, Q, R and S wave. So this is called a QRS complex. Okay. The QRS complex is the combination of three of the graphical deflections seen on a typical electrocardiogram. It can be ECG or EKG signal. So it is a P wave, this is the Q, this is R, this is S and this is T, and total it is called as a QRS complex. And this is the spike. This will be a feature to detect a different kind of heart disease, like if it is normal or abnormal. So we are going to use it, these things. Okay. This is the R. Fine. Now, what is arrhythmia? Arrhythmia is a problem which the rate of rhythm of your heartbeat. The problem in your heartbeat, heart rate. Okay. So like here you see, this is a normal heartbeat and this is a irregular heartbeat which you see here. So two kind of heartbeats are normal and abnormal. It means that your heart beats too quickly, it can be too quickly or too slow or with an irregular pattern. That is called the arrhythmia. What can be a symptoms of that? Fast or slow heartbeat, skipping beats. We'll discuss that is what is skipping beats. Lightheadedness or dizziness you will feel, chest pain, shortness of breath or sweating also you will feel because of this issue, arrhythmia. Okay. Here, types of arrhythmias which we are going to predict using machine learning. First is trigeminy. Trigeminy is two kinds. First, trigeminy can be that two normal heartbeats you will get it, followed by one extra. In this graph you see, this is small one, two are normal and one this you are getting extra. Or just vice versa, one normal and two extra beats you are getting. That is called trigeminy. Second is ventricular tachycardia. Okay, so this is the abnormal heartbeats, means your heartbeat will be fast. Is a fast abnormal heartbeat. It starts in your heart's lower chambers. There are two chambers in your heart, lower and upper. You will get in the lower chamber, it is called the ventricles. So this is the abnormal heartbeat, second graph which you see, that is called ventricular tachycardia. Another is bizemini. So as I told that there is a skipping of beat. If the heart is skipping a beat or having rapping beats, it is called a bizemini. So here you can see, this was the normal which you see, but these are the high in the heartbeat. No? This is the abnormal which you see. So three kind of arrhythmias are there which we are going to predict in our case. Okay. Okay, the inputs the features which I am going to use for that. Amplitude, height of the R wave. The R wave is what? This. How to find out the height of R wave in MATLAB? It is very easy to do it. Simply, if I switch here, if I plot wall, so I will get one figure here. Sorry, just wait a minute. Okay. And if you want to find out the amplitude, just simply you have to give command find peaks and give the wall, you will get the peak value. This one feature we are going to use it. Okay. And if I see in the figure, all peaks are detected, you can see here. So we can take maximum peak. So what we can do, just we can save this data, let's say A is equal to something. I will get all peaks, then do the max of A, you will get the R wave. That is a 946. Okay, So like this, we have to extract the features. Height of the R wave, we are extracting it. Then RR interval. RR is interval is the time between QRS complex. First QRS complex, then second QRS complex. So in normal, the value lie between 0.6 to 1 second only. Then speed. For adult 18 and older, a normal resting heart rate is between 60 to 100 heartbeats it is per minute. Okay. So these features we are going to use for training a machine learning model. And further, we are going to use age, minimum age which I have in my data, that is 23 to 89, and gender if a person is male or female. Okay. So these inputs and outputs we are going to use to train a model. Okay, I am switching here in MATLAB again. So data, I split it in two parts. I will let you know from where you can download this data. Okay. So in sampling, testing data and training data. So let me open this training data and let's see what columns we have in this. So we have an amplitude of that R wave and the distance between, spacing between two complex, and the speed is normalized. We divide by 100, so it is normalized. And the age is showing here, and gender if a person is male or female, and this is the arrhythmia type. B is that we discussed, N is the normal in this case. Okay, so there are three kinds of arrhythmia, three kinds of available there. Fine. This is my output. This is my target. So here you see the output is not a numeric. So that's why it is called as a class, and we will use classification for this. Okay. So here is the code. You can download this data from here, GitHub. So I use, actually yesterday I download this data for you only to show you. Data set you can get it from here. And further, what I am going to do here, I am reading both data, training data as a table and testing data. And to apply MATLAB operators on this kind of data. Just switch me again here. Let me show you one thing more. To apply on character, if you want to apply MATLAB operators on characters like gender and this output, arrhythmia. So here we have to convert this both column as a category. You cannot apply any operator on the character. So you have to convert as a category. So same thing here, I am doing it, reading both gender and arrhythmia column, we are converting as a character, and we are saving again in the same place, same column. Okay, category, and it will be saved in a same place. So we read all training data and testing data. If I give this command summary, it will tell me that what things are available there. Amplitude, total number of how many rows are there, what is the minimum value, median value, max value, same for the RR as well, speed, age, and all this. This is summary of data. Now we are going to plot the histogram of it. So first of all, we are plotting the histogram of age, then histogram of male and female, that how many males are there, how many females are there. Then types of arrhythmias we are going to plot it. This is for the training data. If I click on this, I will get the graph. So you see, this is the age. So if I click somewhere here, let me tell you, on x-axis it is showing ages, on y-axis number of counts of patients. So if I click somewhere here, so what it is showing you, between 69 to 70 years, total number of patients are there 2,263. Okay, this is the histogram. Okay, next, just wait a minute. Next, this is the gender, how many males are there and how many females are there. So males are more if we compare. So total females are there 627. And if I click, how many males are there? When you have to this is showing here 2,304 males are there. Okay, and this is that type of arrhythmia. So here you see here what I did here. this different kind of arrhythmia are less simples. So when you are going to use data, always remember this is the normal graph is so much, it is higher. You make it as a uniform. When you are using data, always try that your this types of arrhythmia and the normal have to be uniform. In my case, it is not uniform. Just to show you, just I use this data only. Okay, this is the histogram of testing data. Fine. Now we have that data. Now further, what we are going to do? We are going to select the which algorithm will be a best for our data. Okay. So I will switch here. I will go here. Then I will choose regression app learner for this. Sorry, not a regression, classification app learner. Let me close this. Because outputs are as a classes, so I am going to choose classification learner. So all these things which it took for you 5-6 months and you can do it within an hour only. So I am going to select that table which I created here there. Okay, so from here that is training data. So you can see here last column is output. I selected last as output. A remaining amplitude, RR value, speed, age and gender will be as a inputs. And again validation, already we discussed what kind of validations are there. I am going to start the model. In this case we have more than 2000 samples which you are going to use it. This is showing you the relation. On x-axis it is amplitude, on y-axis it is RR. Based on the color, these are showing classes. Yellow class is showing this is T type. Blue one is showing it is B type. Okay. So if I change here, let's say that I am going to choose speed. So this is showing the variation. So always remember, when you are going to train it, it has to be not correlated with each other. So like you see, blue is different, yellow is showing in different group. It has not to be superimposed, not has to be correlated. If any variable, any feature is correlated, just from here deselect that. You have an option to deselect because that is a redundant feature. You don't require two similar kind of features, right? Further, you can use PCA also to convert the dimension of your features to reduce is further. Okay, here also I am going to use all quick train, then further I am going to click train. So what it will do, it will train this three algorithm issues, and in this case you see this tree method is best. And if I click here, the accuracy is like 99.2%. If I click on this confusion matrix, so this is a confusion matrix. On x-axis we have a predicted class, on y-axis we have pro class. What it is showing you, this green one, from B group 38 are perfectly classified as a B and 17 are misclassified as a T group. Same for normal. You see that in normal case all samples are perfectly classified as a normal. That's why I was saying you have to equalize all kind of classes, otherwise it will be a overfitting. Same for T group, you can see 22 are perfectly classified as a T and 17 are misclassified here. No, 22 here is a perfectly classified as a T. Okay. Same for VT, you can see 30 are perfectly classified as a VT and 1 is misclassified as a normal in this case. Fine. After that you can create it as a model, export. You can export it as a model or you can generate a code also. So I generated a code and I just use this code in a live script just here below. So what I am going to do, I am going to call that function here. My model will come as a trained model. And now further, what we are going to do, already we splitted data for the training. I am going to predict on that training data. So we will use this model dot predict fun, and this is by what? This is my table. So I am going to take 1 to 5th column only, not output. Okay, output we will use for the accuracy. So 1 to 5 column it will read it in this case. So here we will get the training value. Now to find out the accuracy, it is very good way what you can do. Whenever this condition will satisfy in MATLAB using double equality, I will get the 1 value. So arrhythmia in the training data, the last column was original output and this is the predicted output from this model. Whenever this condition will satisfy, I will get value 1. By giving some command, it will count that how many truly trained, truly output is predicted. Okay, and divide by total number of samples. By numeral command, it will count total number of arrays into 100, then you will get the accuracy in percentage. So it is showing you that perfect on training validation also, on testing also my accuracy is 99.35. Fine. Now further I am going to plot the confusion chart. There we saw the confusion matrix. You can by command also you can plot the confusion chart by giving the original class and predicted class. So if I run this chart, I am plotting of testing training data first of all. The same we saw it there. Okay. So next, what I am going to do here, I am predicting on testing data, and I am going to find out the accuracy on predicting value. Sorry, means testing data. So in testing data also, my accuracy is 97.84. Previous one was actually training which we used it. Here we are predicting on testing data. Okay, so accuracy is 97.84. This is perfect. Now confusion matrix, confusion chart, original output and predicted output. So here you can see that if I am talking of B type, 7 are perfectly classified at B and 4 are misclassified as a T and 1 is misclassified as a VT. So again 707 normal patients were perfectly classified as a normal. In T type, 5 are perfectly classified as a T and 7 are misclassified as a B. So either you can compare column wise or you can go for row wise. So here you can see in case of B, 50 are perfectly classified as a B, 50 are misclassified. In case of normal, 99.4% are perfectly classified and 0.6 are misclassified. Like that also you can identify, or you can go like this also. If you go row wise, then normals are perfectly classified as 100%.